Look, it's lovely to be asked, but I couldn't. Not with Kat being away.
Forget Kat. Can't you smell the chemistry between us?
You're right. Come here and give me a kiss.
Hey, hey, oh! Oh! What's going on here? Like, cut it!
Thanks very much, Ant. What's the big problem, hmm?
Well, for a start, the show started.
Huh? Oh, hello, everyone! Didn't see you there, sorry. We were just reading through the new series of Hollyoaks, written by me and Ant, starring me and Ant in every scene.
Mm. And secondly, Declan, the line isn't come here and give us a kiss. It's no, I can't because of Kat. Go and kiss Ant instead.
Well, yes, I know that's in the script, Ant, but come on. Nobody's going to believe she'd want to kiss you.
It doesn't matter if they believe it, does it? If it's in the script, it's a soap opera.
What's in the script?
Me snogging you.
My agents told me never to work with children or animals. And my doctor told me never to snog them.
Oh, well, you don't mind cuddling up to him, though, do you?
Listen, mate, I've rewritten the script the way I want to do it. And funny enough, you're not in this scene because you're lying in a hospital bed after falling headfirst into a sewage farm. So why don't you pop off to the toilet and practice your big stunt?
Well, right then I will. Lovely work with you.
Yeah, you too. Thanks.
See you later, love.
Bye-bye.
Now then, where were we?
We were about to kiss.
Oh, come here, you. I like the rewrite you've done on this, mind. It's good, isn't it, eh?
Wait till you see what's coming next.
I can hardly wait.
Oi, what are you doing?
What do you think you're doing?
Hang on a minute. Who are you?
We're Cat's Big Brothers.
Lion.
Grr.
And Squirrel.
And you, my friend, are in the kicking of your life. Oh.
And here's what's coming up on the rest of the show.
Spin City are going to be so big that if I stood next to them, they'd make me look tiny.
I think they're already that big, Dec. What do you call a Pokemon waving a parrot?
A polywag.
No, a polywhirl.
Why not a polywag?
Because it's my joke, Pokemon, and I say so. Get on with it.
Okay. Pokemon, it's coming up shortly.
Hi, Ant fans. There's another moment of your musical magic coming up later in Ant Song.
What ridiculous career will Ant be adopting this week in his bid to become Whiff Blast Hand champion? Tinker, sailor, soldier, spy? It doesn't matter. He's still gonna cry.
The cast of Hollyoaks are helping us out all morning, so send in your faxes and emails. And Robbie Williams dares to challenge me, yes, me, in Celebrity Challenge Ant.
Now, believe it or not, someone said this week, Chums is the greatest sitcom ever made.
Wasn't it your mum?
I can't remember who it was, but whoever it was also said Dec is by far and away the best ever.
Ah, right, so it wasn't your mum?
No.
And Savage Garden, Destiny's Child, Ultra Naughty and Ronan Keaton make CDK more fun than seeing a magician cut your sister in half, then forget how to put her back together again.
Hey! A great show!
It's a little one.
It's going to be a small show, but a great show.
Yes.
If you know what I mean. Let me tell you about the Saturday Morning Squad this week. We are so popular abroad that this Saturday Morning Squad come from Mexico.
No.
Yes? They are the SMTV Fandango Fan Club. Okay, shut up now. Like it. Silencio. Silencio, I said. You see?
It's good, that.
I'm fluent and in 47 languages. You see that?
That's very good. Shame none of them are English. We've also got Gene and us here this morning, ladies and gentlemen. There are the Surrey Starlets and there are SMTV Weather Girls!
The cheerleaders were casting aspersions on your intelligence.
Oh, thanks, Ant fans.
How would you like to ring to win? You can. And I'll tell you what you can win. You can win a games console and a four-wheel Thunder game plus two remote control trucks. That's what you can have. We've got a bit of an ooh from the Mexicans.
It's the trucks.
All you have to tell us is who hosted last week's show in place of Kat. Was it A, Richard and Judy? Was it B, Carol Vorderman? Or was it C, Kylie Minogue? If you think you know the answer, give us a call, 09013 801 801. Coach, it costs you no more than 25 pence. Please get permission before you call. We'll be announcing the winners on next week's show.
Now then, listen, don't forget, everybody, we've got the cast of Hollyoaks and Atomic Kitten in the studio today. It's going to be good. And you can get your questions to them. You can email us, studio@smtvlive.co.uk, or you can get in touch with us through our website, which is www.citv.co.uk, or just simply fax 0207 737 8393. But now, though, time for some fantastic pop action here with their debut single, Landslide. It's the Pretty Gritty Spin City!
Come on, get them finished or none of you will eat tonight. None of you hear me? One, two, three, cross. One, two, three, pearl. One, two, three, knit. Hey, you all right there? Hey, you all right? Lying down on the job, slacking it. Get back to your knitting. That means the rest of you are working for another 12 hours. Oh, don't ow me. You've only been working for 3 days without a break already. Oh, hello there. Didn't see you. Ant. Shut up. Stop knitting, everybody. Stop knitting. Oh, all these lot just persuaded me. Let them knit for a couple of minutes while the band were on. Sorry, they just love the knitting action, the little nitty tykes. They love it. No.
Mr. Donnelly, please, can we have some more?
More? More wool? Of course. And stick another sheep through the blender. There's a good lad.
No. Some more water. We haven't had any in 3 days.
3 days? She's only joking. It's only two. Go and sit down.
Hey, Declan, tell him that one back there. She's not working. Shall I go and give her a really hard Chinese burn?
Don't be silly. We don't do that type of thing around here. He's joking.
Eh? Yeah, yes, I'm joking, aren't I?
Yeah.
Just messed about.
Who's on the Pokedex, Ant?
Well, it's Joanna from Hollyoaks.
Lovely to see you, Joanna. You looking forward to doing the old Pokerap with the boys?
So excited.
Yeah, get yourself over on the old Pokedex there, Ant. What happened to the Poker Jumper?
Well, you told us only did it half of one.
Yes, the bottom half.
Ah, so that...
Exactly.
Oh, right.
What's going on?
Nothing. We're just deciding who's going to say hit.
All right, and who is?
Me. Hit it!
Come on! Come on!
Oh, yeah. Come on! SMTV is the place to fight if you want to have a battle with Magnemite.
You better get wise and avoid being flops and get your hands on Cabotops.
He's quite brave, you have to join the queue. If you want something quick, you get a Pikachu.
Pikachu. SMTV will make you pop top.
Maybe 9:25 on a Saturday. Don't be a jigglypuff.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, please, write to your MP. Free the Pokemon one!
Hey, well done, Pokemon knitters. Got me little bit going swell. And Joanna, well done over here. I was just thinking there, you probably now don't want to rub your chest and go, Pikachu, do you?
Not really, no.
Don't mind if I do, do you?
Pikachu!
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 Pikachu, good Pokemon.
Pikachu!
I wanna be the very best. Part two of Pokemon will be here in a little while. But first, thanks to all of you who phoned in and complained that I'm running some sort of slave labour racket with the cheerleaders. Thanks. It's gonna make it very difficult for me now to make any more Pokemon jumpers. But there is a way you can make jumpers for yourselves!
Yes.
Yes, indeed, all you have to do is send in for this. It's our Pokemon jump and knitting pattern.
Huzzah! This really is a genuine offer, ladies and gentlemen. It's costing our producer an absolute fortune. And if you're still not convinced by this, this could be yours. If you're still not convinced, then take a look at this.
Hey, you two. Yes, you. Still trying to impress women with cheese? Cheese went out ages ago. Don't you know knitting is the new rock and roll? And what knitting pattern are all the stars following? Why, it's the brilliant SMTV Live Pikachu jumper, of course. To get your free knitting pattern, then pick up the phone and dial this number. Calls cost £1.50. Yes, just a whackhead £1.50. This is a genuine offer. Be the envy of your friends and attract beautiful people to you. The SMTV Live Pikachu jumper. When will you make one?
Hey, what? Give us a call, give us a call. This could be yours. Go on phone now while the adverts are on. See you in 3 minutes.
Go.
Don't go away.
Go.
Thanks. Very good. Now, normally, this is the part of the show where we'll be delving into the old SMTV post bag, rummaging around, a few of your letters. This week, we didn't get a single letter.
Aww. Shut up! Shut up! You always say this, and then we always have loads of letters.
No, seriously, this week, we didn't get a single letter.
Nah, I don't believe you.
You don't believe me?
No, I don't believe you.
You don't believe me?
No, I don't.
Well, maybe you should ask our postman, Ant.
What?
Huh? Do you want to ask the postman?
Aye.
Pat, come in, Pat. Pat, how are you?
It is. It's our postman, ladies and gentlemen. This is really serious.
Well, stop laughing then.
Okay.
And Kate, stop laughing as well out there. And the rest of you, stop laughing. Stop laughing. Pat. Kate, shut up. Pat, tell him.
He's joking! That's squillions!
Thank you very much.
Please keep your applause going for our postman. His name is Pat.
Give him a
take a bow.
Yes. Get out of it. Oh, he's a good lad. Don't know what his accent was meant to be, but he's a good lad.
He's joking.
He's joking.
We've had squillions. Listen, thanks for all of your letters, the squillions of letters we've had. This first one today is from Thomas Grogan, aged 4. He's from Middlesex. Thanks for your letter, Thomas. He says, who needs the biggest crisp ever? I have found the hugest Frosty in my cereal box. Enclosed is the biggest Frosty possibly ever known to man.
Let's have a look.
Can you get a shot of that?
Look at that!
You see that? And but, save your impressiveness. Is that a word? Can we look that up? Save your impressiveness because look, he's enclosed an average sized one as well there. Comparison.
Right, look at that. It's the size of somebody's head. Look at that.
Ooh. Look at that. Right between my knees.
You get it.
Look at that.
Well, there you are. Maybe it's the size of my head, ladies and gentlemen. Look at that. If you've got any big sort of cereals, send them in. I've got a letter. This one says, Dear Ant Dec and Cats, I've been reading a book about birds and I found a magpie's name in Latin is Pica Pica from Matthew Berry. Really?
That could have something to do with Pokemon, do you think?
Nah.
Right then, following on, you may remember last week we had somebody who said they thought they found a bit of an ant lookalike.
In Greece.
We've started a bit of a trend here. This is from...
I just got a common face.
This is from Jacob from Belfast. And he says, Dear Ant Dec and Cat, my name is Jacob Stevenson. I watch SMTV every Saturday. I'm the world's biggest fan of your show. Although you are all great, Ant is my favourite. And I even try and act like him. Poor boy.
What dopey.
I've enclosed a picture of myself doing that face Ant does at the start of Challenge Ant.
What face?
Well, the face I'm going to show you.
Right, okay.
The ugly face. That ugly face you do. He says he'd like to have a show himself one day called Challenge Jacob. It's a good idea. I can see where you're coming from. I see what you've done with that. You've kind of taken a format.
You've taken Challenge Ant.
That's already
stuck a Jacob on the end.
Yeah, I like that. I like that a lot.
Clever.
He says, please could you read my letter and... keep
Get to the phone, or...
He also says, can you say hi to his best friend, Jeffrey? Hello, Jeffrey in Belfast. But look, do we think that looks like Ant at the beginning of Challenge Ant?
No way! Do we reckon?
Can you get
Do we reckon? Yes? No?
Do the same face.
What face?
That face, look.
Yes?
Yeah, well,
it's close. It's
challenge Jacob. Challenge Jacob. Challenge Jacob. Challenge Jacob. He won't be as bad as you, though. Challenge Jacob.
Leave it. Leave it.
Challenge Jacob.
Leave it. Because, once again, now we've come to the end of the normal letters, and it's time I'd like to just please all the Ant fans out there, hi Ant fans, because it's time once again for Ant Song, ladies and gentlemen. And that's not forced applause.
It's real applause.
They do it on their own accord.
They go mad for it, man.
This week's song is from Jenny Howland and Louise Smith. They're both 14 and they're both from Middlesbrough. And the vibe is like a reggae sort of ska sort of going on.
Ah, yeah, man.
Yeah, man, Irie. Are you feeling Irie?
Ah, yeah, man.
Good.
Nice one.
Shall I go and get ready?
Please
do. Before the intro.
I'll do the addresses, man.
All right, man.
Okay. Go and get yourself ready there. If you want to write us or send us any songs, any big cereal, any big crisps or anything, you know how I like my big crisps, then please get them in SMTV Live, PO Box 22122, London SE19GL. You can email us, studio@smtvlive.co.uk, or you can get in touch with us through our lovely new website. It's at www.citv.co.uk or fax us on 0207-737-8393. I've got the feeling he's just about ready. Can I go and get ready while you come on? I'll go and get ready.
Irie, ladies and gentlemen. Here I am, Irie. So there we are. I've got myself ready. Bit of a reggae mood on this one. This is from the two girls in the Middlesbrough. I've lost my hat. Where's my dreads? Hold on. There we are. Okay. This is a little bit of a tribute to Chums, this one, and then you'll get the beat of it, and you'll be able to catch up. How are you? So here we are. Here we are. Probably the best one yet. Please do sing along at home. So I think if you're ready, why don't we just hit it?
Chums, hey, wake up now, get out of bed, cause Ant Dec are saying, what can? I can't wait till Saturday to see what's next. Ant Dec says,
of course,
we are Chums, walkie donkey, and spent to the phone goes on.
What are you all laughing at me? You're laughing at me.
You look stupid. Now, hang on a minute.
What?
I heard this song earlier on in the week. And that's not how this song ends, really, is it?
No, it ends a different way, but I, you know.
Why didn't you do the different way?
I just didn't want to. It was too long.
Too long? Too long?
I couldn't do it.
Let's listen to how it should have ended up.
What? Does anyone have a clue, ladies and gentlemen? No, I don't think you do.
Here's part two of this week's Pokemon.
Which one would be best against Cloyster's hard shell?
Welcome. It's Whiplash time once again. And how about this for a bout? Introducing the challenges. Gets me every time. First lady from Newcastle upon Tyne, the king of the ring, the belle of the bear, the pasty white hope of the wrestling rope. Clench every muscle in your pants and welcome the fireman. Fireman!
Get out! Get out! Yes, that's right, ladies. I'm a fireman. That's right. I've got smoke coming out of my ears, I've got fire in my belly, and I'm hot. But enough of that dodgy curry I had last night. I'm the fireman, Dec. The fireman gonna rain down blows on my opponents.
The fireman.
Fireman.
The fireman is a force to be reckoned with. By day, he rescues cats up trees. By night, he rescues trees up cats.
This is rough. Ant, is this the best you could do with a fireman?
What?
Give us your special moves.
Wait. Okay. Well, my first one is a backdraft.
Backdraft?
Yeah.
And how does backdraft work then?
Well, it's quite obvious, really. I just stand around with my back to my opponents, turn around and create the waft. It's not bad, actually.
Well, you weren't joking about that curry you had last night either, dear me.
I've got more. My next one, slippery pole.
Yeah, I want to talk about your special moves, though.
No, that's one of them. Slippery pole.
All right, what's that?
Basically, I've got some lard here, and I put it all over my body like that, right? And that means my opponent can't get a hold of it, and I stand really still. And then when they touch us, doesn't affect us. You see?
Can I give it a go?
Why not?
All right, then.
Go on. Give it a go. Go ahead, do what you want. Go ahead, hit us. Hit us as hard as you want. Won't bother us. Won't even affect us. Oh. Oh. I need a bit of work, that one.
Hey, tell you what, though. If I was a betting man, I'd put a lot of money on you winning today.
Really?
Sorry, did I say winning? I meant whining. Sorry.
I've got another one. I've got the human fire extinguisher. Like the sound of that one, do you? Eh?
How does that work? I'd like to see
it. Well, I'll show you. Basically, I get some water like this, and then, you're cold. In the opponent's face. And then that sort of... that knocks them out, doesn't it, basically?
No, it doesn't knock them out, and it just makes them very mildly irritated.
Oh, right, okay.
You're going to need all the moves you can muster today, my boy, because have you seen your opponent? He's bad. Bad. She's demolished the last 2 weeks, the last two contenders. They're still in hospital having their wounds licked by nurses. In fact, yeah, they can't lick their own wounds. They've got nurses licking their wounds. That's how bad they were. Oh!
Well, what are you on about? Hold on. I think I'm here. I've got to get back. There's a smoke alarm going off in the studio.
Stay here. Stay here. Ladies and gentlemen, you're going nowhere. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the next contender. Well oiled, well hard, well over 3'6". You've guessed it. It's the Monster Man Destroyer!
Hi, Mummy. Start the video now.
Monster Man Destroyer, how have you been preparing for the big fight? Have you been running marathons? Have you been crushing double-decker buses? What have you been doing?
No, I made this for you.
Oh, see. So this man with no body and one arm and his heart ripped out and on the floor, that's supposed to be the fireman, is it, when you finish grappling with him, yeah?
No, that's you.
Oh, see.
I love you.
I've heard enough. Challenges enter the ring.
Right.
Yes, it's 2 falls, 1 submission. Our impression of a monkey to win. Let's get ready to rumble. And off they go. What a fight this is going to be. The challengers enter the ring and they start wrestling. Yes, she's just sitting there though. The Monster Man Destroyer is just sitting there playing with her dollies. Oh, she's completely ignoring the fireman. What's he going to do? He's climbing up on the ropes. He's not actually climbing. He's going up in a fireman's lift. He's past the first rope. He's past the second rope. He's at the top of the ropes. And now he's going to slam down from the top of the ropes. Here it goes. Oh. Never mind. Well, he really needs to pull something out of the burning hat now, ladies and gentlemen, if he's going to have any more of this fight to go. Yes, go on, fireman. Come on, fireman. Yes, I say. Oh, no, it's not. Oh, that looks painful. The Monster Man Destroyer now, he's going to hit it where it hurts. It's below the belt. He's sitting there laughing at all of her dollies. Oh, that's not on. But now she's mad. She's taking a run up. She's lifted a knee. Oh!
She got lucky that time.
That all means that the Monster Man Destroyer is the new Whiff Bless 10 champion.
Take his all.
Welcome back to SMTV Live this fine morning. We're all being joined by two very special bunches of guests. We've got Atomic Kitten and the cast of Hollyoaks!
Now, before we get into a quick chat, I've just got to mention that Hollyoaks has got 2 new books out and we've got 20 to give away this morning before they hit the shops. And if you want to win one of those, books, all you've got to do is answer this simple question. Got it? The question is...
What is the name of the pub in Hollyoaks? Is it the dog in the pond, dog in the sea,
or the dog in the kennel.
There you are, and the address to write to is?
Lisa?
SMTV Live, PO Box 22122, London SE19GL.
So there you are, if you want to win yourself a book, get writing in. Now that leads me on to the first email I've got here. This is for the Hollyoaks group. It says, is it true there are going to be some Hollyoaks books? We know that. And if so, what secrets are we going to learn in the books from Laura Buckfield in Somerset?
Gary knows all about this, don't you, Gary?
Have you read them?
I've read mine, yeah, I
wrote
mine.
You just flicked through it there, right? Any secrets in there, do we know?
Yeah, the secrets, well, yours is what? The love, liar, and the lord.
The love, the liar, and the lord, yeah. About Finn, just sort of background of my character, I think.
Mine's all right, so it's about the two characters.
Yeah, mine's all about the storyline, really, and like, the way Luke dealt with it and everything, you know.
Right.
Like, all the pain and anguish he went through, and now he's hopefully going to get over it, I hope.
Of course he will. He's a strong guy. He's a strong lad.
The lad who plays him is, but I don't know about the actual character.
Joanna got one for you here. It says, now your character, Jerry, she's a bit bitchy, isn't she?
Ooh.
Are you like that in real life?
No.
I can back that you are.
I'm not. Declan, no, you know me better than that.
No,
I'm not. No. No, like that. I'm friends with him.
Don't you but let the cat out of the bag now, haven't you? No, you're not, are you? You're lovely in real life.
Yeah.
It says though, what's the naughtiest thing you've ever done in real life? And who argues with most on set? Who do you argue with most on set? Do you get on? There's people on set and stuff?
Yeah, we all really get on. I argue with James a lot. We don't get on.
Why is that?
But do you know what it is? It's because, you know, like when you're younger and you fancy someone, you argue with them. I think that's why he argues with me.
Nah, you see. Secret's
that's
out
not
now.
The reason. That's not the reason I argue with her at
all. All right.
Okay. I just don't like her.
All right,
I've got an email here for a Tommy Kitten. It's from Holly Simpson in Doncaster. She says, what's the best bit so far about being in a Tommy Kitten? Because there's been a few. The advert in Japan and everything.
SMTV. Of course.
I'm just
performing and
the videos,
being on stage.
The videos.
You have shot an advert, haven't you, for Japan?
We have.
Yes. You are huge in Japan.
Yeah, we're about 2 foot bigger than what we had here.
You are huge in Japan, though. You spend a lot of time promoting over there and doing a lot
of
stuff.
We've been there 5 times now.
And we're touring over Southeast Asia
in the next couple of weeks.
You get loads and loads of presents.
No, but we get loads of money!
Well, it's honesty. They don't normally answer them like that.
That's
like
even
that
better.
One.
We like that. Gary and James, what's it like being teen heartthrobs?
Gary knows all about this.
What's it like?
Gary knows the answer to this. I don't know.
James has the most fan now.
Don't you?
Well, I get a few letters.
Oh, look at
that. You get teddies and stuff, don't you?
Yeah, I get the whole lot. I'm quite lucky, actually.
You should
see what's in some of my letters.
Oh,
a little present they send me. Cut.
Going on. Kath Bancroft's in. Do you either of you have girlfriends as well?
Girlfriends, no. Unfortunately.
No.
Do you prefer blondes or brunettes?
I don't know. There's three gorgeous looking girls sitting next to me, plus the two we work with as well.
That must be the best bit about being a teen heartthrob. Surrounded by all
getting to sit next to ladies like this.
They're being modest old girls, but do they get lots of attention on set and stuff when you're on location and that?
They give the extras lots of attention.
Oh, do they?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they do, that's true.
I think we really find out what kind of lads are. Here's another one for Atomic Kitten, who is the bossiest in the group. Who's the vainest and who's the most argumentative? That's from Claire.
All three times.
Why is that?
No,
she's the bossiest.
She's definitely the bossiest, and she's like, oh, they got me.
This is the most argumentative, and she's the vainest. Definitely.
Wait, so she's the bossiest.
And I am not the most argumentative. All right.
I'm not going to argue with that. Happy girls. What was it like supporting Steps on their recent tour? Was that
amazing?
It was the hat.
We ended up calling them Stops in the end because they called us another name.
Something else called
Right, no, we won't go into that.
But it was really good.
Go on, girl.
Party for 2 weeks. Not stopping. Is that good?
Are you going to tour yourselves? Are you going to tour
hopefully next
hopefully
year.
Do next
a theatre tour early next year.
So go out and buy the album when it's out and we'll
work. October. It's called The Good, The Bad, The Kitten.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. Nice little plug there. This one's for Hollyoaks. For Lisa. Everyone is young and pretty on Hollyoaks, but who out of the cast is the vainest and spends the most time in front of the mirror? From Gary Robinson in Scotland.
I don't know, but I definitely know it's not girls.
It's not the girls.
It is the guys. Whenever we're
getting bad press here, fellas.
We're always waiting for the guys.
Is it?
Is that true?
Who gets called at 7:30 for makeup?
Yeah, because you're ugly.
Ladies and gentlemen,
gentleman, our co-star, James Redmond.
Listen,
get on.
Another one to the Hollyoaks gang, to the girls and the boys. Would you, any of you like to move on and work in film?
Yeah, all of us,
we
I think.
Can probably.
Yeah.
If so, would you like to do a, like a romantic kind of film? Who would be a romantic co-star?
Brittany.
Kat.
I mean, oh, well done. One or the other, tough
call. I've just seen Mission Impossible 2, so I think it might have to be Tom Cruise. Tom,
oh, is it?
Tom Cruise.
Something like that.
Yeah.
Tom.
I'd have either of you two.
No, you're just... Well, listen, it's been wonderful talking to you. Will you stick around and have some fun later on in the show?
Oh,
all of you?
I've got to get off, mate.
Never mind.
Anyway, give it up for the Atomic Kitten and the cast of Hollyoaks. It's time for a very special challenge.
It's a special one, this one.
He's face to face with a really special challenger. Challenge Ant.
Yay! Yeah!
Challenge Ant. Challenge Ant. Challenge Ant. Celebrity style.
Welcome once again to Challenge Ant. Celebrity style. This is the part of the show where Ant tries to prove that he's cool. But today we're going to put one of the Geordie Gasbag's more outrageous claims to the test. Without any further ado, let's bring him on. It's Mr. Ant McPartlin.
All right there, Dec. Hello. Hello, no one. Hello.
How are you?
I'm good, you know.
Welcome to Challenge Ant.
Thanks, lots.
Out and about on the road.
Mm.
A celebrity Challenge Ant.
Like a tour.
Like a tour thing. Like Ant, the rules for Celebrity Challenge Ant are simple. Ant selects a subject, makes an outrageous claim about it, then one of our celebrity audience draws up 10 secret questions, the answers to which they know. Ant, what is your claim?
I know everything there is to know about Robbie Williams and his musical career.
What? Even more than, I don't know, say, Big Bad Bob himself?
Possibly.
Let's find out. Here he is. It's Mr. Robbie Williams.
Well, how are you, Robbie?
All right, thanks.
You all right?
Yeah.
Now, you got your 10 questions with you there?
Yeah.
Can I have a copy of them?
Yep.
Can I have them once?
Yep.
Have you had any help with your questions?
Yeah.
Who helped you out?
Matt, we were up all night in the budget hotel that you put us up in, and my mum helped me revise.
Would you like to say thanks to your mum for helping you out?
Thanks, Mum.
Straight down. Yeah, that's the one. That's lovely. Now then, today, Rob, we're playing for the top 10 sports cars in the SMTV chart. And we're talking big money.
We are.
We're talking... If they were real, unfortunately. Rob, you still can't drive, can you?
No, so but I've got them.
We're playing on the model ones.
Okay.
For every question that Ant gets wrong, you'll get a model car.
Okay.
At the end of the 10 questions, you decide whether you want to gamble everything you've won so far on today's star prize, which, look, it's this.
Have a look at it.
That's what we're playing Woo! For today.
Oh, it's skill.
It is skill.
If Ant gets your killer question correct...
Yeah.
You will lose the model cars and you will lose that. But if he gets it wrong, you can drive away tonight on that fantastic little motorbike there. That's all yours. But first you have to win the chance to have it. Good luck to you, Ant.
Thanks, Dec.
Best of luck. I hope this all goes very well for you.
I'm confident.
Good. I kind of see you winning, but hey, who knows? Rob, do you think you'll walk away here with all 10 and the star prize?
I'm not leaving at all.
Good. Yeah. This sounds like it's going to be a great game. Let's play Celebrity Challenge Ant. The question one today is for this one. It's the Ferrari Modena, which you've bought, haven't you?
Yeah, I've got one of them.
Yeah. Well, just give me that then.
No, it doesn't work like that.
Right.
Question one, please, Rob.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Question one. What year did I leave? Take that.
95.
And month?
August.
Oh, shame. It was June. No! 1995.
It was 95. You didn't get June. Should we give him it?
Yeah, go on then.
1-0 to
yes!
Ant.
Yes!
Yeah.
You did get 1995.
Skill!
First one to Ant. Question two is for this. It's the Jaguar E-Type.
Ooh.
Very nice.
Classy motor.
Classy motor.
Classy motor. Question two.
Quasimodo.
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 Quasimodo's motor.
Yeah, there you go. Question number two. What's the name of my American album?
The American album?
Aye.
You're out of time.
Yeah, you're out of time.
Ego has landed.
Oh, of course it is.
Of course it is. It's 1-0.
Yeah, thank you. Oh, brilliant. I do get a kick these as well.
Yeah, you do.
It's not like other shows where they don't give you your
award.
No,
you can have it.
All right.
This is one of those cheaper ones. Question three is for this. It's the Porsche 911. It's a turbo.
Brilliant. Brum. But skill. Three. What football team do I support?
Portville.
Yes. It's two, what I want.
Well done.
Of course it is. Yeah. Of course it is. Question four then is for this one. It's the silver Chevrolet Corvette.
Which soap have I appeared in?
EastEnders.
Yeah.
Yes!
Oh, he's right.
Oh, hey!
Three, one, one. Is it right you're on the phone?
I was on the phone in EastEnders.
In the background.
In the background.
You do Top of the Pops at the same time.
Yeah.
And you nip next door.
Hey!
Do I get another motor for that?
No, you don't. No.
Is that something you like to do, acting? Would you like career in acting?
No, thanks.
No?
No.
I wasn't offering it, I was just...
All right, I thought you got like a job or something.
No,
in
no,
your
just
back
for, no, it's just for the cause.
Right, question five.
Question five for this, it's the BMW Z3 Roadster 96.
How many Ivan Novello awards have I won?
Three.
Yeah.
He's busy, right?
Is it?
It's 4-1.
Look at that.
Steaming into the lead.
All right, then.
4-1. You've got loads of awards, though, Rob.
Yeah, I have. Everywhere I go, I go down the shop, they give me an award for going shopping. The other day I bought some milk and they said, congratulations on buying this milk. And I had to thank passers-by.
What's your favourite one?
What's my favourite one? The great one was once that I got voted like out of top five best musical person ever. And like, I was the only live one in it.
Right.
All the others were dead.
Hey.
So that was nice, kids. Ah. Question six.
Question six is for this, the Ferrari Testarossa 57. Would you like that?
Yeah, I wouldn't. Question six. Take a look at this video and tell me what it's called. What is it called? I don't wanna be sleazy. Baby, just tease me. Got no family plan.
Houston, do you hear me? Ground control, can you feel me? Need permission to land. So there it is. And what's it called?
Rock the DJ.
That's really wrong. Give me the Ferrari.
Oh.
Is it?
Yeah.
What is it then?
It's called Rock DJ.
Oh,
yes. Yeah.
That you think, you're thinking about the Clash there, Rock the Casbah, weren't you?
No, I wasn't thinking at all.
All right, good.
Tell us about the new single, Rob.
Tell us about the new single. It's right, nice. Question seven.
It's for this. It's the Black Ford SVT F-150.
That's nice as well, isn't it?
It is quite nice, that.
It's nice. Okay, question seven. Which of my songs was performed on Celebrity Stars in Their Eyes?
Angels.
And he murdered it.
Angels.
Eh?
Is incorrect.
Is it?
Correct.
It's 4-3.
It's Millennium.
Oh, it came on the show.
Emmerdale.
On the show. What, did you not like it?
Eh?
I don't know, I didn't see it.
Did you not? Well. No, but I'm sure he murdered it. There we are.
Question eight then. For this, it's the Porsche 911 Carrera 97. And for this one, we're going to turn things on its head a bit. Ant's going to ask a series of quick-fire questions. If Robbie fails to answer one or passes on any, then Ant will get the car.
So you're going to ask me questions?
I am.
Go
ready?
On then.
Quick-fire.
Go on then.
Simpsons or South Park?
Simpsons.
Simpsons. Steps or S Club 7?
S Club. There ain't no steps like an S Club 5.
Right.
Yes.
Dinner or disco?
Dinner wasn't.
Or disco?
Oh, dinner.
Dinner.
Yes.
Chelsea or Man U? If you had to choose.
Yeah, you've got to choose. This is the thing you've got to choose.
Man U.
Yeah.
Coronation Street or EastEnders?
EastEnders.
Yep, indeed. Blondes or brunettes?
Brunettes.
Brunettes. Mark Owen or Jason Orange?
Mark Owen.
Mark Owen. Boxers or pants?
Boxers or pants? Pants.
Pants. Arena concerts or festivals?
Oh, arena concerts.
Arena. And the last one, Monica or Rachel?
Rachel.
Yeah. He answered everyone.
I'm a Rachel man. He answered everyone. So he does, he gets it. It's 4-0.
Oh.
It's getting very tense here. I don't know if I can take much more of this. Question nine then for the penultimate car in the SMTV chart. It's this. It's the green Jaguar E Coupe.
Got that as well. Mm. In real life. Right. Oh, I forgot I'm answering a question.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Sorry, I was just gloating. Who have I done a duet with on my new album?
Kylie Minogue.
Yeah.
It's 5-4.
Come on, Ant.
Back in the lead. Did you enjoy that?
What, that last question?
No, the duet.
You said you did the car.
The duet.
I did enjoy doing that,
she's
actually.
She's great, Kylie.
She's lovely, isn't she? Like, she's a friend of the show as well.
What was she like to record with?
Very professional. Very professional. It was nice being with her.
Was it?
Yeah.
Is there anybody else you'd like to work with? Duet-wise? Any other artists?
No, they're all dead.
Really?
Yeah. I'd love to work with you two.
Would get
you?
Away.
Yeah, I would actually. Let's do a song together.
Shall we?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Like Stepping Stone, but good.
Moving swiftly on. The final question is for this beast. It's the Ferrari 99 F50.
What sport features in the She's the One video?
Ice skating.
And what was the ice skater's name, the little girl?
What was her name?
Yeah.
Sally.
Sorry. It was Frank.
Look at that. And at the end of that, look, it's 5-5. Well done to the both of you.
Yeah.
Fives each. That was nice.
Equally matched.
Skill. But there's still a little matter of a killer question. And this little monster here is up for grabs. Now, Rob, this is your decision. It's a very tough decision, but it's one I'm afraid I'm going to have to push you into. You've got 5 model cars here. If you decide to gamble and go for the killer question, you can get the other 5 and have the bike as well. But if Ant gets your question right, you'll go home today with absolutely nothing. Oh. Not even the horse you rode in on.
Really?
No, that's it. You're going home with nothing. It's your decision. What do you want to do?
Well, I'm going to go for the bike.
He's going to go for the bike. He's going to go for the killer question. You join us at a very, very tense moment here on Celebrity Challenge, and Robert Williams from Stoke-on-Trent, his interests are fast cars and singing.
Jet skis.
Mm. He's won 5 of the 10 cars. He's decided to gamble those 5, go for the other 5, and the star prize of the bike. It's a big gamble, Rob. I hope you've done the right thing.
I think I have, you know.
And good luck to you also.
I'm confident,
Dad. Confident. You're sitting there in your robe, all high and mighty. Mm-hmm. Let's hope this pays off.
Yes.
Good luck to the pair of you.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Can we have today's killer question, please?
How many top 5 singles come from my album, Life Through a Lens? Life Through a Lens.
6. 5. 6.
Well, we've got, what chance are we taking?
I'm even going to let him go on with the time here. I know we've run out of 5 seconds. And 5 or 6, you really have to make a decision.
5 or 6.
5 or 6.
6.
It's 3.
Yes! Oh! Get in! I've got a bike! Skill! Thanks, mate.
Fantastic. Well, he's made up. There it is. That's his. He goes away with it. Unfortunately, all Ant goes away with is this. There you are, Ant, my old son. You know where it goes. You know where it goes. Once again.
He is good.
Rob goes away with all 10. And the bike. Thanks to Monkey Bike UK of Leamington Spa for the star prize. And a big round of applause for Mr. Robbie Williams, everybody. More Challenge Ant very soon. Time now, though, for a quick break. Don't go away. We'll see you after it.
Previously on Chums.
Where do you think you're going? Don't you want to hear the report we did for Cat Daily?
Yeah, it's a very interesting read. It's all about 2 ratbags who tried to get girls around as playthings and cleaners and didn't treat them very nicely at all. Now, be good little men and scream.
Is Dec Fearson a cat out of hell? Find out in this week's Chums.
Chums is filmed in front of a live audience. Well, almost.
Dec,
shh.
Dec, shh. Dec, why don't I just go and buy a light bulb? I know it's not my turn, but I don't
like. For once in your little life, will you just shut up? Eh?
I'm trying to plan a surprise party here for Kat coming back from her holidays so she doesn't give us a rollicking for treating those guests rubbishly last week.
But that was my idea! Your idea seems to be hiding behind the sofa ages before she's coming back!
What if she comes back early, young man? What if she comes back early? Have you thought of that? I don't think you have you?
Well, if that happens, I'll gladly eat me hat. Twice.
Oh, you may be regretting making that kind of wild statement soon, son, because I can hear footsteps on the stairs.
Oh, Dec, but that's only just the...
Shh!
But, Dec, that's just...
Shh. Surprise!
Surprise! Surprise party for me? Really? Do you know, I must tell you this, right? In all my life, I've never, ever had a surprise party thrown for me. Not me, never!
Well, here's an even bigger surprise.
What's that? Not two in one day.
Yes,
two.
This isn't your surprise party.
No.
Yours is next door.
Well, I better go back there then, shall I?
Well, not really, because it's not going to be much of a surprise now, is it?
Oh, yeah. Well, perhaps in the next life then, eh?
Maybe, yeah, perhaps. Maybe.
Okay. Mm. I've got a letter for you, though.
Oh, thanks very much. Next time, just pop it through the door. No need coming in trying to scrounge tea and biscuits.
Well, the reason I've done that is because this parcel, what I got in the bag, I couldn't fit for your letterbox.
A parcel? Is it for me?
Is it for me?
Well, I don't know who it's from. It says here, to Cat Deely, top secret. So I don't know who it's for at all, you see? Apart from the fact it's for Cat Deely, perhaps. I don't know, if your name was Cat Deely, you might think you had first dobs on it, I don't know.
I'm Cat Deely.
No, I'm Cat Deely.
I'm Cat Deely.
You're not Cat Deely.
I am.
All right, then if you're Cat Deely, what does she look like?
What does she look like? Well, she looks exactly like me, only completely different.
Ah, just get out of here.
Give us the parcel and do one.
See you.
Hop it.
Thanks, Hoosty. Ah, there you are, right? Parcel to Cat Deely. I'm Cat Deely.
I'm Cat Deely.
Deck. Both of us know we're not Cat Deely.
Ah, so you admit it, so I must be Cat Deely.
No. Cat is our flatmate, isn't she? Mm. She's due back in a week. The parcel's for her. We've got no right to open. Let's just leave it here.
Okay, good plan. Yes, makes sense. I agree with you. Great stuff. Wonder what's in it. We could just open a little bit of the side.
She'd never know.
She'd never know.
Come on then.
I'll just take a little bit off here.
Yeah, go on.
Oh look, oh clumsy me.
Oh.
I've opened loads of it, look.
Well, you might as well just open the whole thing now,
right? Yeah,
well, would you like a hand?
No, I'll do it myself.
You see, I tried, but there you go. Hey, let's have a look. What is it?
Oh, it's just another layer of wrapping paper underneath it. Oh, hang on. There's a note. Look at the note.
Ah, no. What does it say?
We cannot read it like. Fickle.
No, but for the purposes of this sketch, I'd like you to read it aloud.
Oh, sorry. Right. It says, look, you nosy little tow rags. This is for Cat Deely and no one else. So keep your greasy paws off.
So technically, if we wore gloves, we'd be able to own it.
Yes, we would.
Yeah.
We would.
Aye.
Got any gloves?
Nope.
Me neither.
Oh. Well, can't say we didn't try. Let's open it.
Hey!
Oh!
Oh, flippity jib. What if it's Cat?
Hold on. I'll get it. Surprise!
Oh, no. Sorry. It's not. No. We were just saying surprise on the off chance. One of you might have been Cat Deely, but you're not.
We're Cat's friends.
Are you?
Are you? Well, come in then. Come in. Why don't you? Come
sit
in.
Down.
Come in.
Sit down. Would you like a cup of tea? Would you like pie and chips?
Yep. No, we won't stop. Cat just asked us round to pick up a parcel.
Oh. Oh, really? Right. Well, that's the parcel there. That's Cat's parcel.
What did she want? Like,
She wants us to look after it until she gets back because she thought you might open it.
What? That, my dear, is outrageous. I can't believe Kat would do such a thing. That's hurtful. To think that she would think us, our flatmates, would stoop to that very level of opening her parcel.
So you haven't opened it yet? Then?
Absolutely not.
Brilliant. We are hoping you wait till we got round. Oh, back in the open.
Whoa, your boat's there. Wait, this is somebody else's parcel. We just can't go and deliver it on somebody's parcel.
Yes, he's right.
I'm right.
Absolutely right.
But if we accidentally opened it playing a game of pass the parcel, then that would be all right, wouldn't it?
Nah. Anybody fancy a game of pass the parcel?
Huh?
Yeah. If you fancy a chance against me, I do play pass the parcel for England, you know.
Well, there you are, Dec. I think these girls are up for it. Let's get cracking.
Well, what about the pass the parcel game? Are we just going to forget about
That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Now, I'll get some music on. There we are, you right. Scott. And here we go.
Cha-cha-cha. And,
yeah?
How long is this record?
Oh, it's the hour-long extended remix.
Right. We're going to be here a mighty long time before we open that parcel then, aren't we?
Well, I know. I'll go and do the music. Come back. It's my go.
Okay. And it's your go.
Wait, hey! Oh, the music stopped! Yes, let's have a look. Oh! It's just more writing.
What's it say?
Ant and Dec, you should be thoroughly ashamed of yourselves. You have betrayed Kat. Please stop now before you lose a friend forever.
They're not very funny, these jokes on the parcel, are they? I mean, come on, let's try again.
Okay, here we go.
Aunt, the needle's stuck. For goodness, turn the music off.
It's not my go yet.
That doesn't matter. It's not a proper game of pass the boss. We only got to hold it. Turn the music off.
Just because you lose it.
Right, I don't know about anybody else, but I can't stand it anymore. I'm going to open it right now.
Cat's going to kill you.
I don't believe this. What am I supposed to do with that?
Eat it with cheese. What do you think? Stick it in the video. It's a video, obviously.
Of course, right.
So, that's friendship, is it? Opening someone else's parcel. Well, I hope you're proud of yourself.
Yeah. Get to the point.
All right. Well, this was supposed to be for Kat, really. But, Ant, Dec, you have 30 seconds. Underneath the doormat is a key. Go!
He's got the key!
I
just got the camera over there!
Aye!
Oh. Look! There's a map!
It's a map!
There's buried treasure down the back of the sofa!
Let's go! What you found?
I found 10 pence!
No, I found a bag of money! Yeah!
We're rich!
You're rich!
Thanks, guys. Nice working with you.
See ya.
Bye.
Cheers. Bye. Oh, how are we going to tell Kat that we opened the parcel, found the buried treasure, then lost it again?
How are we going to tell her we betrayed her trust? How are we going to tell her we opened a parcel? How are we going to tell her we betrayed her friendship and her love?
How are we going to tell her there's nothing? Absolutely nothing except pie and chips in her bedroom. It's true.
We never did read this letter. How are we going to tell her? How are we going to tell her? How am I going to tell you what we've got to tell her? Freeze frame!
What has Dec got to tell Kat? Apart from the usual lies about not peeking at her in the shower, do pie and chips really work? And does anyone care? Find out next week in Chums! So what exactly was in the letter?
Well, don't tell anybody, but it said... Oh, hello, I didn't see you there, you cheeky little mongrel.
Ah.
This is Lolly, and girls just want to have fun.
Yeah.
What it said.
Just time to say a big thanks to all the guests on the show. Thanks to Atomic Kitten. Yeah! A massive thanks to the cast of Hollyoaks for being down. And a huge thanks to Spring City for being down on the show. It's been a good show.
Can I tell you what, guess who sneaked in the back door?
Who?
The blinking, blooming CDK audience. Morning, audience.
Oh, there we are.
I'll tell you who they're here to see. They're here to see Ron and Keenan. They're here to see Ultronati, Destiny's Child, and Savage Garden, plus the People's Choice, and of course the CDK Saturday chart. Number one! Oh, there's too much. Don't go away. See you after the break.